同学们，你们好，你们最近怎么样？好，今天我们继续学习第九课。你儿子在哪儿工作？现在我们复习，复习，复习生词。跟我读。小猫，狗在哪儿？那儿，桌子、椅子下面。现在你们读，你们读，开始。开始。很好。这是桌子，这是桌子。现在我们复习方位 （directions）。桌子下面，下面，桌子下面。上面，桌子上面。很好，then left。左面，桌子。左面，很好。Then right，右面，桌子右面，很好。上面，下面，左面，右面。Could you please practice one more time? 右面。Now, this time we practice longer. 在桌子上面, on the table. 在桌子下面, under the table. Remember, 在。在 plus a direction or location。现在我们练习。在桌子上面。很好。Now this time。We practice, say that one more time. Together. 在桌子上面。在桌子下面。在桌子左面。在桌子右面。很好. Last time we've learned 在. So, 在 can plus a location or direction indicates the location of somebody or something. The formula is subject plus 在 plus the location or direction. For example, 比如, 请你读。Yes，我在学校。Second one，妈妈在家，妈妈在家，很好。 小狗在椅子下面。One more time, 你读，再次你读，开始。很好。If we don't know the places or locations, what can we ask? For example, the first sentence, 我在 I don't know where you are. Then, what can I ask? How can I ask? Yes, you can say, 你在哪儿？请你读，开始。Answer. 很好。Second one, we don't know where mom is. How can we ask? Yes. 妈妈在。Yes. 妈妈在哪儿？请你读。回答 ,answer, 回答。很好，很好。第三个问题，小狗在椅子下面。现在不知道 ,we don't know, 我们不知道。不知道 means don't know, 我们不知道小狗在哪儿。What can we ask? 小狗在哪儿？ Answer, 回答。很好。这是桌子。这不是椅子，这是桌子。回答，小狗在哪儿？很好，小狗在桌子下面。Or you can say, 小狗在那儿。The dog, the puppy is over there. There, 那儿。小狗在那儿。Okay, now this time I ask you, you answer me please.回答我，小狗在哪儿？很好。小猫在哪儿？回答 ，answer， 回答。Or you can say， 小猫在那儿。很好，小猫在哪儿？很好。Now you ask me, please. 小猫在那儿。The kitty is over there. 很好。Now we've done reviewing all of the things we've learned last time. And now let us check the homework for last time. 作业，回答问题。你的小狗在哪儿？你有小狗吗？你的小狗在哪儿？第二个问题 ,the second question, 你的杯子在哪儿？你的杯子在哪儿？OK, 回答我。我的杯子在桌子上面。我的杯子在桌子上面。很好。第三个问题，妈妈在哪儿？很好。第四个问题，爸爸在哪儿？ 很好。第五个问题，你的朋友在哪儿？很好。现在我们继续学习第九课，生词。跟我读，工作，儿子，女儿，医院，医生，学校，老师。很好，再来一遍，再读一遍。工作，儿子，女儿，医院，医生，学校，老师。Now, this time, you please read it by yourself 1 minute. And how? 现在我们再读一遍。很好。One more time, let us do it together. The first one, 工作，儿子，女儿，医院，医生，学校，老师，我是谁？我是史老师 ，right? Okay, now let us explain some words. The first one is 学校。学校 means school, but it's just means school. You don't know it is university or primary school or middle school. So,be careful with 学. Actually, we're familiar with this character. We have learned 学习 or 学 means study or learn. So, you can say 我学习汉语. I study Chinese. Or you can say 我现在学习汉语. Now I'm studying Chinese, right? 汉语 means Chinese language. 学 or 学习 means study or learn. 你是学生, you are a student. So we have different word with 学. The first one in our lesson is 学校 means school. 你在哪儿？我在学校。我在学校。史老师在哪儿？史老师不在学校。史老师在家。学习 or 学 means study or learn. The example is 我学习汉语, or 现在我学习汉语. This is 学生 means student. 你是学生, 我是老师, right? And then maybe you want to know how to say university. Actually, these two characters are very familiar with you, right? This is 大. We've learned that last time. It means big. But in here, it doesn't mean a big school. It means university. 大学. 大学 means university. Then could you maybe guess how to say primary school? The opposite word of 大 is 小. 小 means small or little. But 小学 means primary school. Now, one more time with these words, please. Can you please read these? 请你读第一个. 非常好. Now, could you please read this sentence? 我在班哥大学学习汉语，我是学生. One thing I would like you to guess. What is 班哥大学? Yes, it means 班哥 University. Yes, 班哥 University. 班哥大学. 我在 班哥大学学习汉语，我是学生. It's very useful, right? If you need, you can write it down in your notebook. And please read it one more time. 开始. 很好. 班哥大学 means Bangga University. Yes. Okay. Now let us continue this word. This is 医院. One more time. 再来一遍. 医院. 再来一遍. 医院. Means hospital. This is the person who works in the hospital. 他是医生。医生. We've learned 学生 just now. 学生 means student. 医生 means doctor. Doctor. 医生. So every time when you see a word with a 生, it always means a person, means a job. Okay. Can you please read this sentence?
很好. 我不是医生, 我是老师. 石老师 不是医生, 石老师是老师. 很好.
So this is all about the new words we've learned today. Can we please read this one more time?
开始. 很好.
Now we're gonna continue with the grammar 语法. Okay? Last time we've learned 在. 在 plus a location or direction indicates the location of somebody or something. For example, one more time, let us read the sentence together. If we don't know the places, we want to know where you are, what do we say? Answer, please. Second one, how do we ask? Yes. Mama, 在哪儿? Answer, please. 很好. Last one. 小狗, 在哪儿? This time, we're going to continue with 在. It's a new grammar point. 在. This time, it is also subject plus 在 plus location or direction, but it's not done yet. We can continue with a verb. Means somebody is at some place, do something. For example, 比如, we can say 我在班哥大学学习. 我 is the subject. 在 where 班哥大学, 班哥 university, do what? Study. So this full sentence is 我在班哥大学学习. 很好. You please read it one more time. 请你读. 开始. 很好. This sentence. Can you please read it? 请你读. 请你读. OK. This sentence is 我妈妈在 医院工作. Subject, 我妈妈. 在哪儿? 在 where? 在 what place? 在医院. Do what? Work. Okay, so the full sentence is, one more time, 再来一遍. 很好. You try it, please. 开始. 很好. 跟我读, follow me, 跟我读. 我的中国朋友在学校看书. Subject, 我的中国朋友. 在 what place? 学校. Do what? Read book. Yes. One more time, 再来一遍. 开始. 很好. Last one. 我儿子在朋友家喝茶. Subject. 我儿子. My son. 在朋友家喝茶. Drink tea. 很好. Now, my question is, how do we ask the question if we don't know the place and we want to know? For example, I don't know where you study. Then how do we ask the question? 很好. You just need to put 哪儿 at the blue box, in the blue box. Then you can say the first one. 你在哪儿学习? Where do you study? 你在哪儿学习? Can you please say the sentence one more time?
回答 answer 回答
很好 Second one, 第二个 Could you please try to ask the question?
很好你妈妈在哪儿工作
再来一遍 Read the question, please.
回答很好
第三个问 Ask, 问
你的中国朋友在哪儿看书
One more time.
回答很好
Last one. 请你读
你儿子在哪儿喝茶？回答很好。
Now, look at this sentence. We want to say something in detail. We've learned 我妈妈在医院工作。But you know that there are so many persons working in the hospital. And you want to say it in detail. You can say,
我妈妈在医院工作。她是医生。
My mom works at hospital and she is a doctor. Then how do we ask the question?
Yes. 你妈妈在哪儿工作?
Now I'm gonna ask you the question. You answer me, please.
你妈妈在哪儿工作?
Answer me, please.
回答。我妈妈在医院工作，她是医生。很好。现在你问回答，问回答开始。
Ask an answer by yourself. 开始。
很好。现在你读我爸爸在学校工作他是老师
How to ask the question?
很好现在我问你回答你爸爸在哪儿工作
很好 You ask me, please.
我爸爸在学校工作，他是老师。
好。Last time we've learned 小狗在哪儿 We can say,小狗在桌子下面。This time, we're gonna learn another question, the way to ask the question.
小狗在哪儿? We can say 小狗在桌子下面。
But this time, I don't wanna ask where is the puppy. I want to ask, is the puppy Under the table. What do we say? Is the puppy under the table? We can say, 小狗在桌子下面吗? Remember this 吗? Do you remember this 吗? Yes, this 吗 is used at the end of the question. When you want to ask a yes or no question. So, what is a yes or no question? Means that the question can be answered with yes or no. For example, this is a yes or no question. 小狗在桌子下面吗? Is the puppy under the table? How do you answer? You can say yes, the puppy is under the table. Or you can say no, the puppy is not under the table. So this is a yes or no question. Ma is used at the end of the question, yes or no question. So it doesn't mean anything, it's just used at the end of the yes or no question. Okay, remember, what do we say? Is the puppy under the table? Can we say that one more time? 一起读。Yes, 小狗在桌子下面吗? How do you answer me? You can say that puppy is under the table. Same, 小狗在桌子下面。Now, this time be careful if I want to say the puppy is not under the table. What do we say? Yes, remember the negative word 不, we put it before the 在。Okay, so we can say 小狗不在桌子下面。You got it? Okay, now this time we use different ways to ask the question. I'm gonna ask you first. 我问你小狗在哪儿?回答我。很好。Second one, 听。小狗在桌子下面吗？很好。Remember, we have another way to answer a question. 小狗在哪儿? You can say the puppy is over there. Yes, you can say 小狗在那儿。Then how can we ask, is the puppy over there? How do we ask? Yes, same. We just put a ma at the end of this sentence. Then how do we ask, is the puppy over there? How to say that? Yes, 小狗在那儿吗? 小狗在那儿吗? How to answer me? Yeah, the puppy is over there. You can say 小狗在那儿。Or you can say the puppy is not over there. What do you say? Yes, 小狗不在那儿。Now, let us try it two ways. Ask an answer. I'm gonna ask you. 小狗在哪儿? Answer me, 回答我。第二个。小狗在那儿吗？很好。Now, let us try this. I want to know where is your daddy? I can say, 你爸爸在哪儿? You want to say, he is at home. What do you say? You can say, 他在。家. Then I want to ask you, is your daddy at home? What do we say? Yes, we just put a ma at the end of the sentence. 你爸爸在家吗? Answer me. Or you can say, 很好。现在我问你，你爸爸在哪儿?
你爸爸在家吗？
很好。So this is all about what we've learned about the grammar today. So we just continued with 在. So the first one we've learned last time is 在 plus the location or direction. It indicates the location of somebody or something. And today we continued with another grammar point. Subject plus the 在 plus the location or direction plus the verb means somebody is doing something at some place. Okay. And now let us continue with the 对话 dialogue. 对话. Okay. 现在你读 then answer my question. 开始一分钟。很好，现在回答我 the first question. Where does B work? Answer me, please. 2nd question. Does B have a son? Answer me, please. Yes, 他有儿子。How do you know?Here. Then my question, last question. B 的儿子在哪儿工作？ Okay, now let us try to read this dialogue. Okay, so let us practice. I'm gonna be the A.You're gonna be the B. Let us practice it this time. 你在哪儿工作？你儿子在哪儿工作？很好。Switch. Okay, you ask me, please.我在学校工作。我儿子在医院工作，他是医生。OK， 现在你自己 ask and answer by yourself. 1 minute, please.很好。Now let us continue with another dialogue. 对话 Easy, right? Let us read it together. 你爸爸在家吗？不在家。他在哪儿？他在医院。很好。Now you ask an answer by yourself, please.很好。Now we just finished the two simple dialogues. Now let us do a practice 练习. You can pause this video and then do this practice. You can write down your answer in your notebook, okay? Now, this is the 作业 for today. 回答问题。第一个 I'm gonna read this for you. 第一个你爸爸在哪儿工作？第二个你妈妈在哪儿工作？第三个你在哪儿学习？ Where do you study? If you're studying at Frere's, what do you say? You can say, 我在 Fairs 学校学习。Next one. 你爸爸在家吗？你妈妈在家吗？ Okay. 很好。So, see you next time. 下次见。